It can be hard enough to predict what will happen next week, never mind what will happen by the end of this century. But based on current trends, future accords, and some educated guesswork, we can make at least a few predictions about what the rest of the years that begin with 2-0 will hold. Here's what the world will look like when it's time to party like it's 2099. India's population boom. For a long time, China's been the reigning champion in the contest to house the most human beings. But a 2015 study of global population trends conducted by the United Nations showed that by 2022, India will be so packed with people that it'll knock China out of the top spot. And the country's population is growing so fast that researchers aren't necessarily sure that this hasn't already happened. These days, scientists aren't as freaked out as they once were about overcrowding the Earth.
Our single greatest problem is the population explosion.
But there's no question that we'll have packed a lot more people onto the planet by the dawn of the 22nd century. 11.2 billion to be exact, which is a whopping 9.6 billion more than we're here in the year 1900. So better claim your space now. Aloha Mars. People haven't been to the moon since the 1970s, but that's okay. We have another goal in mind now, walking on Mars. In 2011, 10 space agencies from all over the world met to discuss plans to visit the Red Planet, with a goal of setting human feet on Martian soil by the mid-2030s. Ultimately, that fourth rock from the sun is considered the likeliest place for a human colony, ideally as an outpost for Earthlings. But it'll also be a good backup plan in the event of our current planet becoming uninhabitable. But we're doing okay, right? Maybe not. See ya, sea ice. According to some data models, the Earth is on pace to lose virtually all Arctic sea ice by 2037. As of 2009, there were 4.6 million square kilometers of sea ice still in existence. If it continues disappearing, in another 20 years we'll have less than 1 million square kilometers left, much of which will be thinner than what we have today, and could end up vanishing under the right conditions. The study in question doesn't say when we might expect the Arctic to lose ice completely, but the general consensus is that if that happens, we're all pretty much doomed.
I'm on thin ice.
The ozone zone.
Recently, scientists discovered a weak spot in the ozone layer over Antarctica, the icy continent at the South Pole.
We don't hear much about it now, but in the 70s and 80s, the hole in the Earth's ozone layer was considered one of the biggest threats to our civilization. If it got any bigger, we feared, the sun's ultraviolet rays would come through it unimpeded and quickly roast us alive. Thankfully, steps were taken to reduce the use of chemicals causing the ozone depletion, and the ozone layer has been slowly but surely healing itself. Still, it's a slow process. It won't be until 2075 that the most damaged part of the layer over the Antarctic will fully heal. Weasels out. Aside from nuclear bombs, few things are worse for the environment than invasive species, which show up in places they're not native to, prey on the local wildlife, spread exotic diseases, and generally mess up the natural order of things. But if New Zealand's plans work out, invasive species like rats, weasels, possums, and ferrets will be eradicated from the island by 2050.
Ice this weasel.
What?
Getting rid of these animals will cost the country over $6.2 billion, but that's a small price to pay for saving the 25 million native birds, including beloved national symbol, the kiwi, who are eaten by these predators every year. And kiwis aren't the only birds in danger. The way of the dodo. According to a 2011 study on climate change, extreme temperature fluctuations might just spell the apocalypse for bird populations worldwide. If global temperatures rise by just a few degrees Celsius, researchers say anywhere from 600 to 900 species of birds will go extinct, most of them from tropical zones, where the temperature stays pretty much the same all year round. If those places suddenly get too hot or too cold, the birds that lack the ability to adapt or migrate to a more hospitable climate won't survive. Or they'll get their revenge. Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto. Right now, robot uprisings are pure science fiction, since none of the AI systems we've created are as smart as we are. But according to Ben Ross, an expert at MYOB technology, artificial intelligence is on pace to match human intelligence by 2040. And by 2060, it'll surpass us, which means we'd better give our robots a solid moral foundation in addition to smarts.
Must kill all you.
Bender, wake up!
I was having the most wonderful dream.
In a TED Talk, Ross told fellow AI creators that they should make sure we guide its pathway forward, ensuring a great outcome instead of bad. In other words, it's up to us whether our super intelligent, super powerful AI ends up looking like Wall-E or something much more sinister.
Open the pod bay doors, Hal.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
Thanks for watching. Click the grunge icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love, too.